I want to take them off.
Now the right foot, Marty.
Right foot.
That's it,
babe.
You
got it.
Okay. Look right here. Nice smile. One, a two, three. Marty. Give me that smile, Marty. One, two, three. Would you step a little that way?
Keep going.
Three down. Towards to the left. Towards Dawn.
No.
I'm back
to
the bride. Her dress is in the picture. Okay. Now, would you come back together, please?
This is it, Bob. They're talking to you. Back with Mom.
Okay. Here I am.
All right. My brother calls
I just got thinking about the big operation Dave Souter had.
I'd like you to turn towards your husband just a little. That's it.
My hands feel
good. Okay, put it behind him. You don't have to show your flowers.
No, not on this one. There, that's better. That's better.
Yeah.
Okay, now look right here, please. Give me a nice smile. Marty, please. That's it. Once more. Right here. Good. Thank you.
Okay. Yeah, we had a picture. We had a picture taken.
Oh,
well, neither one of you had you along with me.
Yeah,
okay.
Beautiful.
You're supposed to be in the middle there.
That's right. There you go. I think I take a picture
today. Thank you.
Three,
give him a kiss. I can't see. Hey! That's it. What? Now come up.
You have to try that again.
Do that.
Stick my neck out. That's probably it.
Okay. And you come in real close to him. And just look this way. Okay. Go ahead. One, two, three, go.
Yeah.
Okay. That's what I want.
Yeah. Hi. Looks, really
look,
this is great.
You looked frightened.
I did? I was.
Now, I want the bride.
Not them, of course.
Oh, that's what he did without crying.
Okay.
He started to.
Huh?
Let's do the grandmother's while they're here.
Yes.
He started to, and then I just looked up and I saw something else.
Okay, look right here. Give me a nice one.
My mother's there.
Right here, one, two, three. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Right, yeah. Room, stay right there.
Oh, man.
You're not going to wreck my car.
No.
Okay, look right here, one, two, three.
Meanwhile, my knees are dancing.
The other back here.
Stop waddling.
You know what's going on.
You look so happy.
Two, three. Very good. Thank you very much.
Show some legs?
Yeah. Okay, guys. Get in real close to her now. That's it.
Oh, wait, you had your finger out.
All right, let's do it again. You ready?
Yeah.
Look good. One, two, three, go. Good.
That was fine.
I like your veil. You look beautiful. Thanks. I don't know. Hun, I'm one very excited young man. No, happy young man.
Whatever.
Thank you.
Our lovely wedding party, and they are lovely. First of all, we'd like to start off with the parents of the groom. Nice round of applause for Mr. and Mrs. Martin Sivin. Nice round. Next, we'd like to have our distinguished ushers and bridesmaids. First, we have Sharon Rutberg, escorted by Tim Moraway. Next, we have bridesmaid and usher Paula and Richard Roberts. Next, we have bridesmaid and sister of the bride, Kim Goulet, escorted by Stephen Kennigan. Next, we would like to introduce our distinguished maid of honor, sister of the groom and best man, brother of the groom, Melanie Sivin, escorted by Keith Sivin. Ladies and gentlemen, would you all please rise? Would you all rise, please? And give a warm, loving welcome to Mr. and Mrs. Todd and Dawn Sivin. Special thing going today. He's going to give a rousing toast. So if you would, Keith, nice and loud so we can all hear you and everyone raise their...
In about June of 1985, I was approached by Todd and Don, who asked me if I would be the best man in their wedding. Never having the pleasure to serve in this capacity for anyone, and being ignorant as to exactly what a best man does, I asked Todd what my responsibilities would be. Todd replied with a list of duties, including writing a speech to be read at the wedding reception. Taking this responsibility very seriously, I sat down soon after and tried to write a toast. I sat and sat, started speech after speech, but could never adequately find a way to express the love that Todd and Don had for each other. I was faced with a terrible problem in trying to write something as strong and powerful as their love. Well, this past weekend, I had the pleasure of driving home with Todd and Don from Syracuse, New York to Spencer, which was approximately 250 miles for a 5-hour trip. During this trip, I was hoping to find out some new and drastic piece of information which I could write the toast about. However, what I found out was not new or drastic, but instead, it just backed up something which all of us here already know. That being that Todd and Don are deeply in love and always will be, no matter what comes between them. During this trip, I was astounded by the number of times that out of the blue, either Todd and Don would say, "I love you." Now, "I love you" is a very easy thing to say, but actually live it is something different. And having been with these two for the last week and considerable amounts of time before that, I know that this is true. The love that they practice is practiced 25 hours a day, 8 days a week, for 366 days a year. Already, this couple has come into complications in their relationship, which would have crippled most couples. In May of 1985, Todd was shipped out to Evansville, Indiana, a distance of some 1,400 miles away from Massachusetts. Even though they kept in constant contact with each other through the phone and letters, they both soon realized that they could not stay apart from each other, and Dawn joined Todd in Indiana, dropping everything she had here. For this separation would have ended most relationships. Instead, Todd and Dawn saw this as a way to solidify theirs, Not from what I understand, I'm supposed to welcome Don into the family and wish the two of them good luck. However, I'm not going to do either of these things. First of all, I'm not going to welcome Don into the family because she has long been a part of it. Also, I'm not going to wish the two of them good luck because their love is something so strong that even if bad luck were to fall on them, their relationship would not be affected. Instead, I would first like to congratulate Todd and Don, and secondly, I'd like to thank them for giving us all something to model our relationship after. We thank you and wish for a fabulous life together.
Cheers. Very elegant. Very, very well done. Nice round of applause for our marriage.
Thank you. I
Once again, nice round of applause for our distinguished wedding bride.
I got my work for 8 nights. Is that about everybody, Don?
Don, be careful that chandelier on the road, okay? All right. We got everybody now? Okay. I got a three. What's up with that chandelier on the road? Thank you.